George Kambosas is sharing his point of view about Twitter wars, and I'm going to tell you guys why I don't necessarily agree with his point of view. But this is what he says from his standpoint. I'm not here for Twitter fights like most of these cats. I'm here for real fights. To be honest, you have to give respect to myself, Teofimo Lopez, and Loma. Out of the one emperor, four kings, and Matrix, we three stepped up and fought, while the others fought on Twitter. Just stating facts, now you tell me who ducks. The reason Teofimo fought Loma, they're both with top rank, was easy to make. None of the other guys are with the same promoters. Ryan's on with Golden Boy. Devin's on Triller. And Tank is with PBC Mayweather Promotions. So it's not easy to make those fights. But the reason more I don't agree with Kambosas on this one, because Tank fought Mario Barrios, who's now fighting Keith Thurman. That's crazy. Who from the 140 guys at 135 stepped up to 140 to fight a champion at 140? Or you could say Ryan Garcia fighting Luke Campbell and fighting Romero Duno. Those were very tough fights that they didn't think Ryan had a chance in them. Won both by knockout. Devin Haney fighting Linares. That's a big fight. Fighting JoJo. So these guys are being active. And even Kambosas himself, he fought Lee Selby in England. Tough fight. Lee Selby's a tremendous fighter. So I can't say. And Loma's had his resume packed with big names. And Teofimo, too. Look what he did to Richard Comey in the 15th fight to win the title. Tank won the title in 16 fights with Jose Pedraza, who now fights at 140 and is about to fight Jose Ramirez. So there's business of boxing that gets in the way. I don't think anybody's ducking everybody. I don't think Twitter wars are a bad thing necessarily. You got to get the fans involved. You got to do marketing. You got to market yourself. If you don't market yourself, nobody else will. So I understand why fighters are on social media calling people out. We all want to see the big fights. I want to see Tank and Loma. I want to see Ryan and Devin. I want to see Ryan and Tank. I want to see all these guys mix it up, A to Z. So that's my point of view. I don't think anyone's ducking everybody. And let's see what happens next. But right now, we'll see who is next for Kambosas. Today, this morning, him and Devin Haney went back and forth. And Devin Haney said, okay, my promoter's going to put up the money and you hold on to my belts. I'm coming to Australia with a vaccine and with everything to pick them up. So stay tuned. It's a 50-50 fight if it does happen. I believe they have the same skill set when it comes to offense. Defense, maybe Devin Haney has the advantage. But George has showed that he's a warrior and he has heart. No quit in him. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Elisek back. Reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. I'm Ellie Secback. Ellie Secback reporting. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.